Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be showing you a beginner's guide to Wild Horse Islands. So first is about the updates. As you can see, it says new update and it will tell you how many days, hours and minutes till the update begins. Then there's the latest update, which you can read on a little guide about the latest update. Okay, next is about catching horses. So you go and talk to Larry, the item trader, and he'll have all of the supplies that you'll need to grow in the game. Like leather, like rope, and like fabric. Okay, so you buy a rope, which you will need to catch a horse. So again, you buy it from Larry and it'll be 50 tokens, so make sure you have enough money for that. Then you go over and take down a tree with your pickaxe, and then you'll be able to craft a wooden lasso. Horses spawn all around every island except for Royal Island and Wild Island. Okay, as you can see, I have found a horse. It'll have a number of clicks that you need to do. So you click the horse that many times and then you will retrieve it. As you can see, this Appaloosa has 11 clicks. And it'll appear in your inventory and you can check the stats and what breed it is. If you don't want the horse, and you just want some extra money, you can go over back to Larry and press sell, and you can sell it for a certain amount of tokens. Okay, about making tack, you will need to buy 5 leather for a saddle, 3 leather and 1 rope for a bridle, and fabric is for polo wraps and for saddle pads. You can pick the color and you can pick the tire. For the tire, you need resources, and also for the color, you need resources as well. Okay, next is about the shopkeepers. This is Stephen, the horse trainer. You tap on what horse you want to be trained and he will train it for you for a certain amount of tokens. Next is Henry, the farmer. So you can go over to him and that's where you farm. I will make a video about this as well. If you want to learn more, stay tuned to the next videos. Okay, next is the hair salon, Sweetie's hair salon. You can go over and talk to her and she will present a Robux die and 2 other dies that you can buy for tokens. She can also style. So you press style and you go on select the horse that you want, and you can change its mane and its tail to how you like it. Okay, next is Abby's accessories. This is where you buy things that you can't craft, like paper crowns and bows, also bell boots. but she also sells saddle pads and polo wraps. Okay, next is Larry, where you get all your basic supplies that you'll need to grow over here, as you have seen. Next is Hogan, the horse seller. He will have a range of horses, one Robux horse, and the rest are token horses. So you can buy those with game money. Okay, next is the breeding center. Again, I will have a video about how to breed, but it is located just next to the town square. They also sell foals if you don't have enough to breed one. Okay, next is about quests. So if you need some extra money, you're bored, or you just want something to do, you go over to the island's person who does quests, which the mainland one is Toby the fisherman. So he will be located up this hill right here. Okay, so you just go over and talk to him. He will give you a quest and you will either receive tokens or items or sometimes both. Okay, next is the map and races. So the races will be located in different places. I am pretty sure that every island has at least two races there. The mainland's ones is Bumpy Beach Race, which you can see is over near Toby. You will sometimes need to complete this race for a quest. So sometimes people are wondering where that race is. Okay, the next race is located next to the breeding center, in between Hogan and, yes, the breeding center. So you just go past Hogan and pretend like you're going to the breeding center, and you will see this race over here, the around town race. You also may need to complete this race for a quest. Okay, the next race is around this very big mountain. I am pretty sure, I think this is the last race. As you can see, there is a little race icon where there will be races. So if you need to locate that, you can look and find the racing icons. The little white arrow is yourself, so you know where you are. Okay, this race is called the Mainland Loop. Again, also you might need to complete this race for a quest. If you need to get back to the dock quickly, you can always reset your character and that'll bring you straight back to the island's dock. Okay, next is William, the boat captain. Right now we are on mainland and there is a lot of different islands to choose from. Some islands need you to be a certain level and sometimes you need to pay for them. But Roleplay Island and mainland is free to travel to, so you don't need to worry about those. Okay, so if there's anything that I didn't mention in this video that you need to know, you can go over to Shella the guide and she will tell you all about the island. Okay guys, that is the end of today's video. I hope you learnt a thing or two about Wild Horse Islands and have an amazing day. Bye!